Wigle Distillery is located in Pittsburgh's Strip District, the first distiller in the city since Prohibition. Stop for the spirits and learn about the history of whiskey in Western Pennsylvania.
Mark Meyer and his family are the owners of Wigle. And Mark, you're going to be celebrating 2 years in the distilling business. This is such a great concept, and you have all your family members involved in this.
We do. We have myself, my wife, my daughter Meredith, and her husband Alex, and then Jeffrey was involved for a while. He was doing some research on the history, and then Eric, our son, is also involved. So it's a very, very family-oriented operation.
And what made you decide on distilling Pittsburgh?
Do this crazy thing, right?
Yes. Yeah, no.
Well, actually, the way it started was we were on a trip in Canada. We were at the Shaw Festival. And so we visited as a family some of the wineries. And there were a few family-owned wineries. So it was actually Alex, my son-in-law, and Meredith who had this idea. Wouldn't it be neat to do something like a winery? So on the way back, as we were driving back to Pittsburgh, they were researching on their phones options. And so we said, we don't want to do a winery. But Pittsburgh used to be known for rye whiskey. So why don't we do rye whiskey? And so one thing led to another.
And did you know anything about the distilling
process? No, not really. No, you know, as you know, you can't legally distill at home. So
yes.
Most people, if they have a background, it's in brewing. And so we spent literally about 2 years reading everything we could. We went to Michigan State. They have a program.
Mm-hmm.
They helped us with our first batches. All of our equipment is from Germany, so we worked with this German company. They were very, very helpful on some of the technical things and helping us work through the initial runs. And so it was really learning from every source you could. Now, what's nice about today is that today there's more of a network.
Saturday is the only day that Wigle Distillery offers their tours. First one is at 11 a.m., and Bill and Lauren are going to be our tour guides to tell us more about the distilling process.
Well, my name's Lauren.
And my name is Bill. Welcome everyone to Wigle Whiskey. Pittsburgh was the frontier. Pittsburgh was wild, and the people here were wild. A German immigrant, a man by the name of Philip Wigle, heard about this Pittsburgh place and thought, no rules, lots of whiskey. He saw a sign for a place called North Versailles. And he stopped a local and he said, hi, my name's Philip Wigle. Do you guys really say it like that? It's Versailles, you know that, right? And the local, true to form, looked right at him and said, listen here, Mr. Philip Wigle. The very first tax in our nation's history was a tax on whiskey. And that does not make the people out here in Western Pennsylvania who are making whiskey and who don't have a lot of money to spare on things like taxes, did not make them very happy.
So we are able to pump about 1,500 pounds of grain through this machine in 20 minutes. What happens is that it goes through this auger, and if I were to pop the top off of that, it looks like a giant corkscrew. We had that grist, that flour, it ground up, carry it back up the other auger, and it goes into what we call mashers. We add hot water, and when hot water is added, the carbohydrates break down into sugars.
Philip Wigle and his friends had just had a tax passed on them, and they were not very happy about it. So he and his friends get together, and they go to the home of a man by the name of Benjamin Wells. And Benjamin Wells had the unfortunate job of being the tax collector for the region at the time. They get to talking, and that turns into a bit of an argument and a bit of a disagreement, and a scuffle breaks out. Back in the day, what really got Pittsburghers going was the news of a good fight. And so when they found out that Philip Wigle punched public enemy number one, Benjamin Wells, the tax collector, they get very excited. Very, very excited. In fact, they get so excited that they start protests, and those protests turn into riots, and those riots continue for years and come to be known as the Whiskey Rebellion. That was us right here in Pittsburgh.
Now we're going to ferment that. This is really one of the most vital parts of making really any liquor. So we have our mash in these containers, and we add the ever so exciting yeast. So once that alcohol vapor starts to come off of the still, it either went through something like this, or it went through something really, or goes through something really cool like this.
We are all sitting here today in the first whiskey distillery in the city of Pittsburgh since the end of Prohibition. So let's finally drink to that.
Well, I think this is a great, fun place. And I love the story with Philip Wigle. I love the namesake and the history. I mean, this really is a true Monongahela story, you know, for Western Pennsylvania. I mean, it really is a great history lesson.
Yeah, and that's one of the reasons we really wanted to do the whiskey, because it really is, it really comes out the Pittsburgh tradition, and it has so many roots in, you know, American history, with, you know, George Washington being a distiller and Thomas Jefferson. He made some whiskey. He's more of a winemaker. I don't think his whiskey turned out to be very good. But it was such a way of life then. But we really, I mean, our mission is we want to be local as much as possible. We want to be organic, and we want to experiment. So we're doing a lot of different things, and we're able to do that because we can build this local customer base. Black Farm, daddy, oh, there's whiskey in the sky.